Stay your hand, stranger. Come, look into the pit. The Lord of Empty Abodes awaits therein. I am his shaman, Nunu. Your coming was revealed to me in the whispering of a bat's wings. You are lost, seeking guidance, yes? Sometimes, the whispers are silent. My lord grows distant. I weep alone in the desert. But there is a cure. The smoke of the lotus. It deafens the world, and so that the whisper of Yogg becomes a roaring shout. And the visions. They reveal to me the will of Yogg. If you need guidance, inhale the lotus. The path will become clear. The paths revealed to you by the lotus will not always be simple. Every opportunity is a test, and every test requires strength and an indomitable will. You cannot simply wander into darkness and expect to conquer. You will need to prepare. Build yourself up and find the other lotus. They bloom in other places and have many colors. I have a feeling, my friend, that you are going to taste them all before you are through. My heart has a question. Do you know the Lord of Empty Abodes? He knows you, child, through the flesh of your kind. He hungers to know more. All flesh is knowledge, every savory thought. Bring us knowledge of others. York is generous. We are exiled without conviction. Our crimes are of no moment. My crime was my belief. What matter the age of the flesh that my lord consumes? Does the Lord of Empty Abodes make a distinction between flesh in the womb and flesh outside of it? Now my tribe walks without a shaman, and I seek the pure flesh to feed my god. Listen to the whisperings. Yogg knows you. Yogg whispered of your return, friend. My lord whispers to me of this place. He walked here in ages past. Here, there was a banquet of flesh for his pleasure, and kings called upon his wisdom. It is men who destroyed that age of abundance. Yogg urges us to seek atonement. The flesh we bring is an atonement, a satiation of past sins.
Put your weapons away, exile.